Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another episode of An Epic Journey Around South America. Today, we are in Punta Arenas, the city of the red roofs, which lies on one side of the 660 kilometers Drake Passage crossing. And we are ready to discover the incredible geological and human history of a city which defies easy definition. This is 14 Days at the End of the World, Episode 9, The Gateway to the Antarctic. Norwegian Star arrived early in the morning in Chile's southernmost city, Punta Arenas, a wind-beaten port of nearly 130,000 inhabitants on the Strait of Magellan, which gained the nickname the Gateway City to Antarctic. Weird enough, when I was planning this cruise, I didn't book any tours here. And therefore, in the morning, I discover myself negotiating the price of a full-day tour with private guides and drivers. The prices were ridiculous high, and the options were limited to a driving tour of the city. When I was one step to start exploring the city by foot, I was approached by a taxi driver who offered me a full day tour of the entire area at a very good price. I didn't think too much and I jumped in his car. A little bit adventurous decision, I would say now looking back. But once again, Saint Christopher, the protector of travelers, was on my side. Aldo, my driver, was a real character with excellent knowledge of the area and a charismatic personality. Cameraman and reporter for the local television, DJ with a very successful online weekly Latino party, excellent photographer. Aldo actually saved my unplanned day in Punta Arenas with some excellent ideas. And we started with a ride to one of the most important national parks in Chile, the Magellan National Reserve, located on the Brunswick Peninsula, 7 kilometers west of the center of the city of Punta Arenas, was created on 13 February 1932 and is now one of the main attractions for tourists and scholars all around the world. Today in Punta Arenas, I'm visiting the National Park of Magellan Strait and Fort Bulnes, an absolutely fantastic opportunity to learn a little bit more about the geological history of this place, to learn about the colonization, different periods in the colonization from Magellan, Francis Drake, and after the Chilean arrival. And it's absolutely not only a breathtaking landscape, but the history, it's absolutely fascinating. Thank you. It is time now for a little bit of history in a special location. Fuerte Bulnes, the first Chilean settlement located in the Strait of Magellan, 62 kilometers south of Punta Arenas. After the arson which devastated the place between 1941 and 1943, the government directed the fort to be reconstructed as a historic monument. The replica includes the church, the chaplain's quarters, the jail, the power shed, post office and stables. It was declared a national monument in 1968. Ladies and gentlemen, let's travel back in time and step into the incredible history of Fort Bulnes. Fort Bulnes is the first Chilean settlement here in Magellan Strait, and it's quite interesting because from the European point of view, when you say fort, you expect very big, impressive stone building, but here everything was made from wood. And even the governor house, the one behind me, show how humble, how simple, how basic the life, and how difficult, of course, the life was in that time. Walk around the Fort Bulnes give you a very good view of how much the humans, they wanted to stay here despite the very hard life condition. And it's quite emotional and quite impressive. The entire fort, it's absolutely impressive. They didn't have any bricks here. So all the buildings, they are made with bricks made from mud and straws. The only wooden houses were the wooden construction. They were the church and the governor house. The name Punta Arenas came from the Spanish term Punta Arenosa, a literal translation of the English name Sandy Point, given to this place during the voyage of John Narborough in 1669-1671. In 1848, Chile set up a penal colony that grew into Punta Arenas, positioned so that the fleeing state could control the Strait of Magellan. Swelled by European immigrants, it rose the 19th century. Patagonia sheep farming boomed to become a wool production center, perfectly placed on a maritime export route. That and local coal reserve founded the European style splendor of the city's mansions. It was renamed Magellanes from 1927 to 1938, but the Panama Canal had robbed the strait of its importance. The slump was arrested with 1945 discovery of oil and now the Antarctic link up. And Aldo was an excellent guide through difficult historical period of the town and found a perfect spot for a late lunch just to try the local delicacy, the spider crab served in 1001 ways.
Thank you.
That's all for today. For tomorrow episode, I will take you to the bridge to have the best views of a famous glacier, and you are invited to a private party. See you tomorrow at 6 p.m. Central European Time on YouTube channel Leonard Myron 1969. And don't forget that yesterday is but today's memory, and tomorrow is today's dream. Thank you very much for watching. See you tomorrow.